on the grass, yeah, on the grass, yeah. I'm sweating in the drawers, yeah, all on day. Yeah. Wanna walk it like a dog, yeah. Rick you off.
Yeah.
You said it was about chicken.
He cooked me some chicken.
Yeah.
And when he gave it to me, it's all pink.
Oh no, you could get very sick.
Yeah, I don't want salmonella.
Yeah, I get them uncooked chicken, but... And you didn't even say thanks, though.
Let me get this right. You work at an audition together?
We were, yes.
You have an argument because he didn't cook your chicken?
Yeah.
Now you're here on your own.
Star, and I've really missed him.
Wait, he's here?
Turn back the hands of time.
Now you didn't tell me that.
Oh.
Still be mine.
But look at him! Look! Look!
I got beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb,
ram, pork,
beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name
it! Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, pork, dog. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, pork, dog. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name
it! Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, creams, potatoes, creams. Beans, 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 potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys, beans, 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 potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys.
You name it! You name it! You name it! You name it!
Do you think President Obama or the FBI was engaged in such conduct?
I'm not going to try and characterize the tweets themselves. All I can tell you is we have no information that supports them.
Were you engaged?
Comey confirmed FBI.
Try very hard not to engage in any isms of any kind, including McCarthyism.
The president second stated, quote, is it legal for a sitting president to be wiretapping a race for president prior to an election? Turned down by a court.
Oh, Donnie, honey. Don the con. Honey, it is 6:49 in the fucking morning. So don't excuse my appearance. Because I can only imagine how you look, honey. Have you got your wig on yet? Anyways, Nobody made up shit about you with Russia or nothing like that. And quit talking about Hillary's campaign, honey. She beat you by how many million? I mean, you're out of your mind. But anyways, anybody got time for that? We don't care about your tweeting, but I want to know, how were you criticizing Obama when you went on all these trips? Racking up the payments, honey. Quit your bullshit.
As someone who's known as one of the first LGBT people to make it big on the internet, I love the fact that some of the people in my own community, specifically gay guys who said I was too flamboyant, are now watching Drag Race screaming, "Yes, queen, slay!" I love that they're embracing femininity and just being who they are. But back when I came out, this was during the Bush administration, pre-Drag Race, and there wasn't that many people around to show it's okay to be free. Back when I came out, they said it was extra and attention-seeking, and it wasn't just seen as me being who I am. And I think Drag Race has changed a lot of things. I think it's made people look inside of themselves and see how they judge people of their own community and accept people. And this isn't about poor me or making myself a martyr. This is about saying whether there's a drag race or no drag race, accepting people, whether they're feminine or not, should be always, not just when it's trendy.
I'm over here starving, man. My belly's rumbling. I'm over here about to die. It's times like this when my belly's rumbling, I start thinking about how wrong I did my exes. I ain't got no one to say, "Baby, what's for dinner tonight?" If I was focused on how tender-hearted my ex was, and wasn't always looking for something better looking, maybe they'd be cooking. You know what? Let me take it a step further. Maybe if I got my sorry grown ass up and cooked myself something to eat, no one else would fucking have to. And then maybe I could cook something for somebody else, and I might be worth a damn. And why is it that it takes me getting to the point where I'm hungry to think about how I treated others in the past? But in the meantime, I'm going to order me some Domino's and think about all my relationships that went down like dominoes. These are the thoughts of a man, y'all. Just letting you in on it. Have a good day.
Those who say they're patriotic, but they turned a blind eye to the destruction that he's about to cause this country. You're not nearly as patriotic as we are.
So what does that mean, Bill? We've been listening all morning. We cannot.
I didn't hear a word she said. I was looking at the James Brown wig.
if we have a picture of James.
Really, Bill O'Reilly? Bill O'Reilly? You're saying she has a James Brown wig. I'm trying to find where your wig is. Because it just looks like all forehead. It looks like your forehead goes all the way to the top up here. Before you comment on a woman's hair, maybe you need to find you some. Talking about a James Brown wig? But yet the man that you support, Trump, looks like a fucking Charlie Brown character running around the fucking place.
And I believe that God is going to bless you with a double portion blessing. That's right. And I believe not just a double portion blessing, but after you get the double portion, God is going to double it again, and double it again, and double it again, until you come to the point where you will not even be able to fathom the blessings that are overwhelming you. And follow divine leading and direction. I believe
what the fuck?
God is a miraculous God, but the Bible says that he will do nothing unless he reveals his secrets to the servants, his prophets. Amen. I believe that God will give me a word for you, but let this resonate in your spirit. Double portion. Double portion blessing. Coming to you. I really believe that.
Spring water. It is spring, isn't it? Is my double chin gone?
Sometimes I think dick is demonic, y'all. I do. After I'm with a man, sometimes my head starts spinning around so good I'm like in The Exorcist. And I start making crazy faces and stuff like. And I said, what has gotten into me? I mean, he got into me, but what has gotten into me? And I have to slap myself back to the Lord-fearing woman that I am. After he gets me bent, I gotta repent. Because I think his dick is demonic, y'all. And sex and It's got me like the Exorcist. I gotta lay off the dick and start praying.
I wanted to make this video because we're living in a society where everybody airs all their business and all of their thoughts online, whether they're having a good day or a bad day. People are either trying to make their lives seem too perfect by only posting the good things, or people do the opposite, where they only post the horrible things they're going through all the time. And here's the thing, okay, I'm just gonna get really real with y'all, that only post about negative things you're going through. Venting is great and it can be a therapeutic outlet, but know the difference between sharing how you feel and dwelling in how you feel. Because a lot of times when we post these statuses, it doesn't really do any good and it just lets our neighbors and everybody down the street know what we're going through. Or we post it because we want the person who upset us to know how we feel. But that's not healthy communication and it's not going to change anything. Talk to someone. I'm going to make this video, not to sound like a narcissist or something, but I'm going to make a video for people who watch my comedy videos of things they may not know about me just watching my comedy videos, because I don't really get to be myself in them. So, number one, I don't think people would assume or even believe that I'm an INFJ because I present myself so loud and extrovertedly in my comedy and my performance art. So that's one thing people would definitely not know about my Myers-Briggs. Another thing is that my grandparents raised me from the time I was 4 years old on. One thing people may not know about me is that my favorite singers are Fiona Apple and Courtney Love. I love their songwriting. One thing people definitely don't know about me is that I was a clogger for 5 years and I would do parades, I would perform at talent shows, you name it. I was a clogger. And my favorite authors are Marianne Williamson, Sylvia Plath, and Elizabeth Wurtzel.
Sometimes in life we stop crying tears of sadness, don't we? We stop becoming overwhelmed with life's problems. But sometimes we realize those problems can turn into eye-opening moments. Just think of that, my darling. Whatever it is that you're suffering with right now, know that maybe it's a moment to open your eyes. So open your eyes with me right now as a practice. Close them first. And 1, 2, 3. Do you see that, dear? Life's brand new again with every eye blink. What a refreshing moment of knowledge. Cheerio, dear. Have a cup of tea and a biscuit.
Hey y'all, it's Parsley. Today's southern word / mountain people talk expression is the word plum. Now I know a lot of times when y'all hear the word plum, you're thinking of a fruit thing. I ain't talking about no fruit thing. I'm talking about, say you just had a meal. Instead of saying that was very good, you'd say, well, that was plum good. Say somebody is crazier than cat shit. You wouldn't say, well, they're very crazy. You say, well, they're plum crazy. Try to use it in a sentence today. Swatch out your normal talk with how we talk and you'll sound like us a little bit. Hope you learned something. 10-4.
Some of y'all just need to give it up. Y'all got this woman so just cemented in your mind. Somebody could be talking about why the sky is blue and somehow it will turn into
but Hillary. You want some Hillshire Farm? Did you say Hill? Well, anyways, about that old Hillary Clinton.
Like, it's pretty extreme when shit that don't have nothing to do with the lady gets put on her. I mean, it really is. Whether you like her or not, you just gotta admit. Everybody has a
but Hillary
mindset. I mean, some of y'all would make an excuse as to why you ain't had a pap smear in 20 years.
But Hillary. I was so damn occupied with her emails, I couldn't get down to my snail.
I mean, this shit is ridiculous. The lady is not a coat hanger. Quit hanging your shit on her. Stay on topic. It's like she's your excuse for everything. Leave Hillary alone!
Hi y'all, this is Parsley. Now this video is a message to the men out there. Sometimes men, you get together and you talk about the women, but you don't really talk to each other about what you need to do. Men, from what I'm hearing from...
comes out and all this goes down, I can't wait. I won't be the first one to get on there and say, I told you so.
About what?
About everything going on.
With who?
I ain't saying.
Trump?
Just wait. If it all, the investigation stuff comes out like they think it might, I want to be one of the first ones to say, told you so.
They'll say, well, what about Hillary?
But what about her? She's not the president right now. There's no need to talk about her. It's done and over. Go. Zilch. Ain't no need to talk about Hillary. She's not the one that we can blame for any of this. As far as I know, but I'm sure somebody will find a way.
I haven't had a man in so long that when I look in the sky, I'm starting to see the clouds as penises. That's right. After it's been so long, your taint starts to hallucinate. And I'm going to need my needs met. My needs need to get met, and I need to get wet. And I'm not talking about sticking my toe into the pool. I'm talking about deep sea fucking diving. I need someone to dive into me like an Olympic fucking swimmer. I need a man to open me up like a can. Get these canned goods, baby. Come on. I've got that no preservatives push. And if no men come my way, I think I'm gonna be a fidget sinner. Sit on this motherfucker for a minute.
I'm not even going to waste my time stating the obvious, which is that Donald Trump is a disgrace, but instead I'm going to focus on saying to all of our trans brothers and sisters out there, don't let his views be reflective of how we all feel, which is that we stand by you, we love you. You walk the walk in a world that tells us to not be ourselves every single day. Please know that many of us will always fight for your rights and know that you are loved. Why are people telling me to respect other people's opinions when their opinions directly affect other people's rights? Your opinions do not outweigh people's human rights. If someone's willing to fight for this country, they should have the opportunity to. If they are qualified, and there's currently 15,500 trans people in the military. So, do I consider it trash that you think people's opportunity should be taken away from them? I do, and I stand by that. The same way I would think it's trash if someone tried to take away anyone's opportunities to be themselves, to fight for the freedoms, keyword, freedoms in this country. That's called standing up for people. Trans people are already one of the most marginalized groups. And I love how a man who dodged the draft is tweeting who can serve. My mother served, my grandfather served, and the only thing Trump is serving is a steaming hot plate of bullshit. And that's
There's all these dicks out here in the world. And sometimes we get like a squirrel chasing one fucking nut when there's a whole tree to see. Why didn't that do that good? You see, we get stuck on one motherfucking nut. And there's all these men out here, all these different kinds of money-making men, and we get stuck on a Slim Jim. Shake yourself loose from that demonic dick that's got you stuck in one way of thinking. Oh, it's the only dick I'm ever gonna love. That's the only stinking dick I'm ever gonna love. La, 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 la. Get the fuck up out of that thinking, bitch. Get your head out of the ground, because that's where he wants it, like this. So your ass is in the air, so you can't think straight. When your head's further to the ground, you can't breathe. Like, bitch, get that man off your mind and make your own money.
Like, I think movies fucked me up growing up. I always believed in a fairy tale and shit. You know, the prince that comes up to sweep you off your feet. They ain't even sweeping the floor, let alone me, off my feet. I grew up watching Pretty Woman. I thought when you pushed a man away that would make him want to stay even more, you know? At the end when she leaves and then he climbs up to them. Sometimes I don't know if they see me as Cinderella or Cruella, but there's an Ella up in there. Okay? You think a man's gonna surprise you with a wedding ring? Only thing you end up at night with is an onion ring. And by the time he knows your ring size, you've already swelled your fingers up because you ate so damn much from stress.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry. I was just admiring the plants outside. I'm doing a video. Today's advice is, never ask me for mine and then not take it. You know, one of the most annoying things in life is when someone says, boo hoo hoo hoo, what should I do? And then you drain yourself telling them, and they don't even have the decency to listen to what the fuck you said. Don't cry on my shoulder and my tits just to do the same shit. If you want to leave the man, do as I say and leave the man. Don't waste my time, or I will block, delete you, and forget that I ever knew you, even if we grew up together. You take my advice, you little bitch, or move the fuck on, you fucker. Thank you.
Today's advice while I take a bite is, mind your own fucking business. Suck a dick. Get a mortgage. Get a 401k plan. Learn how to tie your shoes before you tell a bitch how to live their life.
They see the sex appeal, but they don't want to get to know the person beneath. And it's like, why should I have to dress different to make you stare
at my soul. I'm more than my washboard abs. I'm more than being a sex kitten. I'm more than my sex appeal. Just want me for my heart and not my parts. Like, they see me running and they think of Baywatch. And it's like, you should see me running and think of a future wife. I'm very settled downable. So I just want men to realize, please, get your minds out of the gutter. Because I know you can't believe it, but this is not butter. That's all.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry. I was just admiring the plants outside. Today's advice is, don't think that that person who you think might be the one, that you can just win them over later on down the road. Never think that you can just have someone when you want them. Oh, that person right there, they're the one for me, but I'll settle down when I'm 50. I don't think so. Let me tell you something. You get it while it's hot on the plate, or you make a mistake. Cause this pussy can't be put on layaway, motherfucker. You get it while the getting's good? Or honey? You gonna be a fool who wish he would. Deal with that.
You know, there's never really much of an upside of things being down in life. But I always try to find something to keep me sane and grounded and functional without having a breakdown. There's been 2 deaths within the family in about a 2-week span. I lost a friend last month to suicide. Someone I knew in LA just recently passed away. My grandmother's health has not been the best lately. And when I look around and I see people arguing about such avoidable things and petty things, it makes me realize that that's a luxury. It's a luxury to only put all your energy into avoidable arguments. It's a luxury to sit on Facebook all day and post shit. It's a luxury when I see people causing drama for no fucking reason. So all I want to say is, even though these times have been really hard, it shows you what's really important. I just wanted to hop on here really quick and say thank you for all your prayers and everything. And it means a lot to me.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry. I was just admiring the plants outside. Today's advice is to have manners and give me your money. Yes, every dollar spent on a Chris Crocker t-shirt will go directly to my lip injections, Starbucks, and affordable outfits to look like a dream come true just for you. I know there's nothing you want more than for me to have a full tummy and to have my lips blown up bigger than your tits. So if you would like to accommodate, go ahead and buy a t-shirt. No secrets here, darling. I've teamed up with my bank account, and we are ready to make my ass bounce. If we collect enough money, I might get this stomach done and this kitty cat. Buy it now. You'll feel proud.
No shame in my game, bitch.
Wow.
When I'm with you, I get as well.
Not the same.
When I'm with you, all I get is.
Not the same. Time,
whoa, shit. No, hey.
When I'm with you, all I get is wiped out.
You know this pussy's for the taking.
Hey.
Now you want to see me naked.
I don't know the rest of the birds.
Collectively, we might all know the words, though.
We got to some, like. Cool, like,
I know you know this pussy for the dick.
Are you absolutely out of your mind?
I know you know this.
Are you absolutely out of your
mind?
What the fuck was that?
Did she say portion though?
I know you're not a portion for the dick.
She said!
I know you know it's bullshit, but I think.
But does she actually?
Hey, bitches, it's Petty Boop, and I'm like an ice cream scoop. I'm gonna tell you why bitches die single today. social fucking media. Social media has made everything like a menu when it comes to dating. Yeah, I think I'll have a number two with a six-pack and abs and, like, these days, even if you have a connection with somebody, if it was right in front of you, you wouldn't even know. People got too many fucking options. Back in the day, you were stuck with who you were stuck with. You liked somebody and they had a pot belly, like a pot belly pig, you stuck with them. These days, people don't know how to hold it together these days because they're searching for perfect. But the ones searching for perfect ain't even fucking worth it. The people saying they're looking for love, they've had love in front of their face 59 fucking times, but they've looked past it because they're too busy looking for a 10 and a perfect body and a perfect pussy and a perfect dick. Like, girl, bye. Girl, bye.
Good for you, bitch. Hi, if someone tells you that you're selfish, maybe you fucking are. And maybe before you respond to what they say, you shouldn't listen. And not just go with you. Not just. See, you were ready to talk, weren't you, fucker? Maybe pause. Listen to what they have to say before you respond, and not just go with what yourself tells you about yourself. Just like this selfish fucker who's riding up the fucking road ruining my fucking video, fucker. Someone says you're selfish, chances are you are. Evaluate. Why are you watching this video? Evaluate the situation and
just wanted to give you all an update that my grandmother got to go home. Thank you all so much for your thoughts and prayers, because they worked and they mean so much to me and my family, and this has been the craziest week of my life, and you guys have been so amazing being there for my family and I, and we thank you and we love you, and it means the world.
Imagine him in the Oval Office facing a real crisis. A man you can bait with a tweet is not a man we can trust with nuclear weapons. I can't put it any better than Jackie Kennedy did after the Cuban Missile Crisis. She said that what worried President Kennedy during that very dangerous time was that a war might be started, not by big men with self-control and restraint, but by little men, the ones moved by fear and pride.
Alright, y'all, just parked at McDonald's, Mickey D's, and I'm gonna try this new sriracha sandwich they got going on here. I'm gonna pop the hood on this thing here and let you see what's going on. They got some crunchy bits on there, crunchy bits of bites, and some sriracha sauce, a little bit of cheese, lettuce, and a little bit of mater on there. So I'm gonna take a bite here and tell you what's going on. Damn. If this thing right here was a woman, it'd be Faith Hill. This is some good old stuff, man.
All these men out there who think they can put the pussy on layaway, settle down when they're 50 years old, let me tell you something. In a way that a man can understand it. Say you go to a car shop, right? And they tell you this is an import ride, okay? This is a once in a lifetime kind of ride. You're gonna get that car
then and there, because you know someone else is going to get it. It's the same way with us fine-ass bitches. Y'all seem to think you can just scoop us up on a rainy day. Same thing with that ride. This is a once-in-a-lifetime kind of bride. So you better get the ring and make that ding-a-ling swing, honey. Put a commitment on a bitch. I'm sick of y'all playing around thinking you can be playboys until you're 50 years old. 50 ain't nifty, honey. You better scoop me up while I still look good in them wedding photos. This is prime real estate. You don't get it, another man will. I damn sure bet you that. You know, when I go through a breakup, I just take it as an opportunity to finally go through all my DMs that was just sitting there. You see this, honey? Do you see all this patty cake, patty cake? They want to be the baker's man, honey. You know what I'm saying? So no, I don't really worry about it because first of all, I don't have an ex that has ever got over me. I've got that magical clavicle bitch. They can't get over the sway of these hips. They can't get over the limp wrist, honey. It's just that undeniable flavor that you have when you've got it like that. You know, when you're a once-in-a-lifetime bitch, you know they ain't no getting over you. That's a mountain many men have yet to climb, honey. I could shit in the floor and they would still want more. So no, I don't really worry after I go through a breakup. I just set an alarm. And before you know it, they crawl right back. And in the meantime, I stay a snack.
Been a long week. My patience has gotten very thin, but I just wanted to hop on here and say, instead of counting sheep at night, I need to just start counting dumb bitches, because I know more of them than sheep. Might as well put them to use for something. Stupid bitches acting like they're in your inner circle. If you think you're in my inner circle, you might need to learn your shapes, baby. Whack ass. Stay focused on you and your loved ones.
Why is it that we can't talk about racist pieces of shit and white nationalist Nazis without people bringing up marches that Black Lives Matter held that got out of hand and went too far? Why is it that people can't just look racism in the eye and in the face and say this is wrong without having arguments about things that do nothing but distract from the actual topic? Why is it that Donald Trump can go on television and say, we condemn these acts of bigotry without calling it what it really is? Racism, hatred, the need to feel superior, the need to fight, to cling to a history that was built on racism. Isn't Donald Trump the same man who criticized Barack Obama for not calling Islamic terrorism by its name? Call white supremacy by its name. If you get lost in arguments about, well, this group was wrong or this group was wrong, you're missing the fucking point. Racism is still a problem in this country. And if you can't acknowledge that, you're a part of the problem. Oh, baby, abracadabra, form of a bedroom. Now add a little candlelight in the scent of your sweet perfume, girl. Hocus pocus, now you in that cute little dress that I like. Now don't lose focus on what I'm about to show you tonight. I can do magic. Whoa. One snap of your finger, girl, I'll perform a trick on you. Oh, anything you want me to do. Cause I can do magic, magic, girl. All you gotta do is dim the lights, and I'll show you a trick or two. Oh, man. Because I can do magic, I can do magic. Bitch, some of you are so fucking jealous, and I don't know if it's because of the way that I'm built. I don't know if it's just the sway of my hips, the way the men respond to me. I don't know if it's because I've been, you know, the one and only one for so long, but it's got some of you in your feelings. And anytime you leave a comment that I don't like, that's you being jealous. Anytime I post a selfie and you don't say, damn, you look good, that's you being jealous.
If I walk past you at the mall and you don't stop me to compliment me, that's you being jealous. Matter of fact, I'm gonna take it a step further. If you're my waiter and you don't leave me a tip for the pleasure of waiting on me, that's you being jealous. If I say thank you and you don't thank me for thanking you, that is you being jealous. And if you're not jealous, then you have a problem too, because you should be.
Help me out here, white people. Because I'm real confused about some shit. And I grew up in the South, in the dirty, dirty South, in the Bible Belt, okay? So if I'm confused about it, I need some help here. What is this white history that they say they're trying to cling to? Trying to preserve with all these statues of slave owners and shit like that. Because that's exactly the history I'm trying to evolve and get away from as a person. If it means that I have white guilt because I think that that shit is fucked up, then sign me up. Like, what history are y'all trying to cling to? The only white history that matters is going forward and making history by not feeling superior to other people, realizing what systemic racism is, and evolving and becoming a better person to do our part in speaking up for people. And it's the same people who are silent who always say, well, why's everything gotta be racist? I didn't do nothing, my ancestors did. Well, if you care about inequality, use your mouth and speak up, honey. Okay, Memo, you know my, you know the, like, dresses and stuff that I get from the thrift store and stuff? They always think I'm wearing your clothes.
My clothes?
They say, take your granny's dresses off and stuff.
I wouldn't wear those clothes to a dog fight.
They think,
my clothes?
They think I'm wearing your dresses. Everyone's always like, take off.
There's no way that I would wear the dresses. No way, the ugly things.
Huh?
I would never wear those ugly dresses.
Well, honey, they think I'm wearing your fashions.
Well, I'm sorry, they're wrong, and I would not wear them.
They think I'm they think I'm wearing your clothes, honey.
I wouldn't wear that junk. I wouldn't even give that away to somebody. I don't know of anybody that would wear it. Except you, for being funny.
Well, anyways, I just had to clarify, because they always say, take your granny's clothes off.
I'm sorry, granny wouldn't wear them clothes.
Hello. Unless you were fucking me, feeding me, financing me, and fondling me, unless you were the Winnie to my Pooh, unless you are the Andre 3000 to my Erykah Badu, it's time for you to act brand new and quit acting like you are up in my business. You got a lot of bitches from my hometown who act like clowns, okay? I've maybe met these people 3 or 4 times in my life, and these people act like they're ready to write a fucking Facebook status every time a bitch burps, every time a bitch chirps, every time a bitch shits. I don't know you like that, girl. I might be cordial to you out when I'm having a drink at the club and say, hi, how are you? Have a few words, but it ain't really that cherishable. It ain't really that cherishable to me. I don't know you like that, bitch. Like, if a bitch looking this crazy right here is telling you you look crazy, ha, get a CAT scan. My pussy ain't a trampoline. Bounce the fuck off, bitch. I don't know you like that. I'm back up on here to let you know that some of you are so fucking jealous. Someone earlier was like, oh, she's thick. And that would be fine if I were thick. Right now, I'm currently 102 pounds. I'm 6'5". There's nothing thick about me but my ego, bitch. You know, I always grew up with the motto, because people always said, well, don't let it go to your head. And I'm like, well, if it don't go to my head, it's going to go to my ass. Take your pick, bitch. But damn, I do look good, especially for 109 pounds being 6'4". But yeah, I do feel that the comments are very slanderous. I do feel that the comments are very jealous. And I do feel that the comments do not showcase me in any real way. I'm just definitely a skinny mini. I mean, I wear an extra small in all sizes. My foot is a size 3. So I'm very little petite for a tall person. And yeah. And to everyone saying that this is a gut, this is a frontward butt. Don't fuck with me.
DJ Khaled! I don't know if you could take it. No, you wanna see me naked, naked, naked. I wanna be a baby, baby, baby. Spinning in his red just like he came from Maytag. Rock a wristed on the brown. When I get like this, I can't be around you. I'm too little to dim down a notch. Cause I can into things that I'm gon' do. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, 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 thoughts. Wow, wow, wow. When I'm with you, all I get is wild thoughts. Wow, wow, wow. for the tag. You know this cookie's for the bag. Kitty, kitty, baby, get her things to rest. Cause you done beat it like the 68 Jets. Diamonds and nothing when I'm rocking with ya. Diamonds and nothing when I'm shining with ya. Just keep.
Hello? I don't want to hear your excuses about why you voted for Trump. You might as well tell me why you put a pickle in a smoothie. Give a fuck. You might as well tell me how 5 + 7 = 2. I don't give a shit. If it don't make sense to me, it don't make sense to me. It don't equal harmony. Girl, bye.
I like this better.
When I eat, I'm just trying not to bite off my lip injection.
Burger is fried, plain broiled.
I know some bitches are really gonna have to lose their attitude with me. Do you know how many times I scroll through my Instagram and I see people jacking my shit all the time? Okay, and I keep it cute, I don't say shit, but when you come around with some attitude like you're a prime sirloin girl and you know damn well you're one of them half-off shrimps, girl, we need a price check on IO9, cause a bitch is getting out of line. Thinking you a 10, but you really just all chin. Don't do me, girl. So apparently, my last popsicle video was too suggestive for people. They just couldn't handle my big lips, I don't think. So I'm gonna try to eat a popsicle in the most unattractive way ever. We'll see if y'all are not offended by this. Let me hide my lips. Is that better? If I look like I have a turtle mouth or something? Cause how the fuck do y'all eat a popsicle?
Talking about, well, that's too sexy.
Well, how the fuck do you enjoy this? That ain't no fun. I know that on social media, we like to keep things light and fluffy and not really go too deep and talk about things that really affect us at times. And that's why I do my comedy and stuff, to deal with my anxiety about things I deal with, whether it's problems within myself, my family life, my relationships. It's an escape. And speaking of escape, something I have kind of always known in the back of my mind is that I'm not compatible with alcohol. A lot of my issues are anxiety related. So when I will drink, because of the fact that I'm always feeling things and always picking up people's energies when I drink, it's a way to numb out. And that's not really healthy for a person that's trying to constantly sort through their feelings. And even though it's not something I even do that often, I am just not proud of the feeling the next day or the person that I was the night before. I'm turning 30 this year, and I want to be the best me I can be. There was an eclipse today. I didn't know. I've been in my man's basement. He has a lot of slings down there and different toys he wanted me to try out. But I feel very robbed of the experience of seeing it. I didn't know there was an eclipse. He had me tied up to the bed with my legs behind my head and all kinds of shit. And I don't know, but I'm really upset. I would have liked to have seen the sun. Hey, I guess that's what I get for fucking on a day that was supposed to be legendary. I was just down there getting the dairy. Fuck it. I didn't see the sun, but I saw some buns, so.
What's up, y'all? I'm home from work. Have me a nice glass of water before I call it a night. Gotta stay hydrated. It helps keep the thirst away. But I just wanted to hop on here and say, there's gonna be a lot of people in this life who make you question your worth, who make you question how great you are. And you don't need me to tell you, but I'm going to anyways. You see, sometimes in life we put our worth in other people's hands. And when we give them permission to do that, they're not really stealing our hearts, we're willingly giving it away. And what you gotta recognize is, when you give away the keys to your heart to the wrong person, you better know a good locksmith. Don't just jump into the first relationship that comes your way. Never settle. And when you feel like you're about to settle, hit the pedal. You deserve so much more.
Yo, bitch ass, and you ain't responding to nothing. What the fuck is you doing? Who the fuck is you out there with? You think I'm stupid? My girls already done put me up on your ass tonight, nigga. When you get home, I got some news for your bitch ass.
Why are you coming home? 5 in the morning. Something's going on. Can I smell your dick? Don't play me like a fool, cause that ain't
gonna say too much. All I'm gonna say is if you follow me on Instagram, go to my profile right now. There's a link in my profile that's not gonna be there for too long. Check it out. I'm really nervous.
So I guess he thought he could find better than me, right? I guess he thought it was okay. But who cares what the fuck I was saying about him? This shit is good. Damn, bitch. I'll tell you my story some other time.
I think here's the problem with trying to date when you're almost 30. Impossible to please. For instance, if the guy shows up at the restaurant before I'm there, if he's already on time, I'm like, damn, he's obsessed with me. Ooh, I'm feeling claustrophobic and shit. If the guy shows up late, I'm already playing on my Tinder looking for the next guy. If a guy calls when he says he'll call, I look at that phone like it's a demon from hell. What the fuck is going on? What kind of fucking supernatural shit is this? But if a guy calls like an hour after he says he's gonna call, straight to voicemail. You can go to hell. Cause I know I plucked my unibrow on that date and you should be wanting more from me. And if they ask me, so are you still a fan of Britney Spears on the date? Huh! The only thing you gonna know I'm a fan of is the ceiling fan above me cause I'm gonna be rolling my eyes looking at it. You're supposed to get to know me, not a meme. And then if they start saying they support Trump, check please. I just need a guy who knows when to fuck on and when to fuck off.
I've said it from the beginning because I believe that we should speak out not just when it affects us, but When it affects anyone, it affects all of us eventually, okay, is the thing. And if you care about people, you speak out. So I've said it from the beginning. And waking up today to the news that Trump is now implementing the ban to get transgender men and women who are serving for us removed from serving, I'm saying it again today. Donald Trump is trash, okay? Not everything he touches turns to gold, like that shitty-ass, fake-ass-looking gold-type shit that he has everywhere. It turns to shit. And anyone with a moral code or conscience who thinks it's okay to remove transgender men and women, you can kiss my fucking ass. I'm the son of a veteran. I'm the grandson of a veteran. And it's just trash, okay? You speak up when it doesn't affect you, because eventually it fucking will affect us all. It's trash.
See, some of y'all go on diets in the spring for your summer bod. To hell with that. You know how many pools there is to lay by with all them nachos and all them stuff? I don't go on no diet for no summer body. I'll tell you what the fuck I do. I'm the guinea piggy in a bikini all summer long, honey. I ain't laying out no hot fucking sun without something to eat on and munch on and slurp on. But you know what I do? When it's almost Halloween time, I'm going on a diet, bitch. Because while the rest of y'all dressing up like goblins and ghosts, I'm going to look like a stripper on a pole. While everybody else is dressing up like M&Ms, I'm ready to look sinful, baby. I'm ready to look like what your man's looking at. Put away the chips, put a peach on my lips, because when Halloween comes, I'm going to be that bitch. I'm going to be sexy.
Sometimes we're all upset, aren't we? Sometimes things go wild. And sometimes it's up to us to really get centered and to really get focused and to really get happy again and to really, really remind ourselves of what life's about. That question can only be answered by your soul. We're all here for a different purpose, my dear. Get focused. Enjoy life. You're somebody.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to today's news. I'm Chrissy, your hostess with the mostest. Today's hot new news is last night, Taylor Swift released her new single. It's called Reputation. The album's called Reputation. The single off the new album is called Make Me Ooh. Look at what you made me do. It's a departure for Taylor. I had a chance to listen to the song myself last night, and honestly, it sounded very different, unique, and very edgy for the girl. Edgy. Edgy is the word I would use to describe the song. Some are giving mixed reviews, some are saying it's great, some are saying it's not. Also, in the newest news of the world, Fifth Harmony had a chance to release their album last night. It was the first album they released without Camila Cabello's. The album is very unique and different. My personal favorite is the song Bridges. That's all of today's news. Tune in next time, baby.
Love, I told myself lies. Why do I rush? And now I'm stuck. The hardest part of moving on is what if. What could have been and who'll be there to kiss your lips? I'm not what you wanted, I'm not what you wanted. So I'll move on, I won't hold on. Thinking what if, what if. Myself, trying to believe I know this game well. My heart is crazy. Not every love is meant to be, but I'll remember what you gave to me.
Thank you so much to everyone who has enjoyed my new song. I was gonna say who purchased it, but really that's not as important as just knowing that you enjoy it. And I know that sounds cheesy, but it really does mean a lot to me. My music is like one of the only places where I put my vulnerability and experiences that I really go through in my writing, because it's not like I'm going to make a video being like, hey guys, this is what just happened with me and my breakup, or like my, you know, I might in my comedy, but it's more hidden, like in my actual songs, you know what's going on in my life. So it is more vulnerable. What is my hair doing? But yeah, I just want to say thank you to everyone that's gotten the song and enjoyed it. It means a lot to me, and I hope you're having a wonderful weekend. And I love you guys. Ah, such a dork.
Other people are not in charge of what you are worth. Other people are not going to put that money in your bank account. Other people are not going to wipe your ass when you shit. So why do we give one, and why do we let them hold us back in life? I want you to love yourself and love yourself right now. If you got one insecurity, I want you to say to yourself, being insecure is not pure, and I want you to hold on to your heart and get to loving yourself, baby, because you are worth something, damn it. You are the best damn beautiful bitch I've ever seen in my fucking life, and I ain't never even seen you. Believe in yourself, baby. Because if you wait for other people to believe in you to make your dreams come true, you better get a slow motion clock, honey, because you're going to be waiting a long fucking time. Believe in yourself and believe in yourself now. La, 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 la. I love you, bitch.
Alright, y'all, I'm stressed out because Trump is a piece of shit, so...
I was watching TV and I saw these and I was like, let me take my ass to the store.
Alright.
I guess you get to use this pan that it's in, honey.
Let's get this bitch like my mood. Hated.
And I definitely don't trust things to be naturally flavorful as they come, so... Mm-hmm.
Parsley.
Okay, bitch. Sprinkle a little salt. Sprinkle a little salt. I'm definitely not one of these white people that thinks damn salt is spicy, honey.
Girl, please.
Put that bitch on the top shelf, because I'm a top shelf bitch. Let's get pregnant. Put the bun in the oven.
This shit better be worth the wait.
You look good, bitch.
Let me slice it around.
Who the fuck is Philip?
I feel like a hog in heaven. Fuck it all.
I'm listening to the new Chris Crocker song. It's really good. I'm gonna sing along.
Why do I trust in my illusions? The hardest part of moving on is what if? What could have been and who'll be there to kiss your lips? I'm not what you wanted. I'm not what you wanted. So I'll move. And I won't hold on, thinking what if.
I've seen some of the dumbest tweets that I've ever seen in my fucking life tonight. Y'all already know where this is gonna go. First of all, in the beginning of the night, I already said, why would I pay $100 to watch anyone fight when I can just start a fight on Twitter for free? Well, Mayweather obviously won, as we all know. Immediately, you guys, I have screenshots of these. There were horrible racist tweets online. I'm not repeating what they were because they're disgusting. It's shit like that that makes me ashamed to be white. I called these people out for their racist bullshit. Then people said to me, well, he beats women. Hi, hello, I'm Chris. I watched my mom get the shit beat out of her by men when I was 2 and 3 years old. I do not condone any violence towards women. But I also don't condone racist pieces of shit from hell. If you wanted to critique someone about something, that's not the way you go about it. The two are not mutually exclusive. And racist, go eat a shit pie. Oh, hello. I'm sorry. I was just admiring the plants outside. You know, sometimes in life, people are going to try our patience, and we can't always be Mother Teresa. Sometimes we're going to be motherfuck you. So, let people know who try to treat you like a doormat. I only lay down for Louboutins, and you're not the one. Let them know if they're trying you today. Darling, if your mouth was only made for bitching, then my ass was made for kissing. Let them know, honey. Yeah.
Hi everyone, I watched the VMA so that you didn't have to. Here's my final thoughts. Britney didn't perform. That's all I have to say. Good night.
Sometimes, as a grown-ass adult, I like to sleep in. And I ain't talking till 12 p.m. I'm not talking till 1. I'm talking till 4, bitch. Okay, because that's my right as a stinking-ass bitch. If I'm old enough to grow hair on my ass, I'm old enough to let the hours pass. Don't tell me what to do. Odds are, if the ponytail is still in my head, I just got out of bed. I ain't listening to nothing you said. Don't talk to me like I'm awake if I ain't. That's the worst part about when you sleep in and everybody else has been awake for hours and hours and hours. Their brains have had time to get going. I'm not on y'all's choo-choo train. My choo-choo ain't even had time to chew. My brain right now is stuck on bruh. Bruh. Don't even. Why do y'all do this shit? It's sick in the head. Why would you talk to an innocent, sleepy person like they're awake like you are? Either give me coffee or get up off of me. Boing.
To all of y'all who used to call me fat, look at me now. I want you to look at me now. I'm 107 pounds. Sitting pretty, bitch. Mm-hmm. You see these thighs? Bitch, I'm so little now, y'all could barely see my ass. Tiny as fuck. And I got a 7-Up diet. That can't say shit now, bitch.
Y'all, you give way too much power to fuckboys. For those of y'all watching that don't know what a fuckboy is, it's a term that has come about because these men sweet talk somebody, but they're really just trying to fuck them. So my opinion is this. I've got needs. If they would just cut out the misleading part and quit trying to make me seem like they want to wife me up, just tell me when you want it, baby. Let me go pick out some pretty panties and shit. You don't need to tell me I'm wifey to come swipe me, honey. You don't need to tell me I'm gorgeous to make me a contortionist. You don't need to tell me I'm beautiful to get you a spoonful. It's all about how they go about it for me. Now, I'm not talking about for you. I'm talking about for me. If a man says, hey, I want to fuck, I'm like, you know, I'll spin my head around like the Exorcist. They can get with this. So to all the men out there, make your intentions known. Don't get to cootie and then put a bitch in a friend zone. You don't gotta tell me you love me to wanna fuck me. Just get the kitty cat. Meow. Fuck it.
Morning people. No, like literally morning people freak me out. I get it. We gotta have them to make the world go around. Somebody's gotta be awake to make coffee. Somebody's gotta be awake to like get things operating. But do you gotta put that extra energy on me? See, when you act like an exclamation mark and I'm not even a dot dot dot, I'm not even a question mark yet. I don't even know what the fuck I am yet. My eyes aren't even eyes yet. And these people are everywhere. You try to order something at the drive-thru. Yeah, can I get a venti, coffee?
Oh, yes, would you like an extra sugar with that? And also, how is your day going?
I'm like, holy shit.
Either these people haven't slept and they're guzzling coffee all night, or these motherfuckers' heart rate must be on hydraulics.
Like, these people are so excited, their fucking eyebrows are in the middle of their forehead talking about,
y'all that excited the birds are chirping?
Y'all act more excited just to be awake than I do when a Britney CD comes out.
Everybody's always talking about the millennials, and I don't relate with the millennials because even though I'm on the internet all the time,
I don't post all these selfies on Instagram trying to act all lavish and shit, acting like, insert glass of alcohol here.
Looking like the damn Terminator and Anna Wintour had a baby, knowing damn well they spent their whole check on that drink.
Okay.
The millennials are out here wanting sugar daddies, $6,000 bags, and fame. And I'm just wishing that food looked in real life how it does in advertisements. So broke my teeth off.
Hard-ass cookie.
So I'm just saying, we ain't all the same. You know, I like to watch Golden Girls. I ain't worried about diamonds and pearls. You dig? Some of us are old-fashioned. No, like literally old-fashioned, honey. They're out here spending their whole check on all these clothes.
And you know where mine goes.
I'm easy to please. They're worried about how many likes their pictures get. And I'm just worried about how many licks my pussy gets.
Men out there.
You want to be cooked for. You want to be adored. You want your feet rubbed. You want to be the man of the house, and you want to be babied. You want your partner to look good for you and dress like they're Amish when they're out in public, because God forbid somebody looks at them. Yo, territorial pterodactyl acting fucking crazy motherfucker.
Oh no, baby, them shorts are too short for you to wear out when we go out to dinner tonight.
But yet you can dress up like a fucking scarecrow that threw on a fucking overall shirt and a fucking dingy-dong looking motherfucking piece of shit like a little dog from hell. You want to speak your mind about politics?
Well, this is what I think, honey.
But God forbid your partner does. You want somebody to drop to their knees and please you. But you can't even get your tongue wet. Well, your partner is not your pet. To keep it 100 with you, this ain't the fucking 50.
Morning, everyone. No, I'm not nude. I'm wearing my usual. I started my meditation early this morning. That's how I get in the zone to find my purpose for the day and everything. And today, my message for you is simple. Try to remember today that even if you get overwhelmed, even if you stumble, even if you become impatient, if you're not treated fairly, you can only control how you react to things. And in a way, there's a great power to that, which is we hold our own and don't give yours away. Meditate on the thought today that there's a beauty in knowing that you're exactly who you're supposed to be. And no matter where you are in your personal growth, in your journey, you're on your way. And you can't be 50 different people and do everyone else's job and work in this life. You're enough, and you're doing great.